Hello and welcome. In this talk, I will share about strengthening our fundamentals of homeopathy through a short story of the fern and the bamboo tree. There was a man who worked very hard and gave his 100%, yet he failed. He was very frustrated and wanted to quit. There he met a hermit. The hermit said, "Look at those two trees. The fern and the bamboo tree. Both the trees were given water, light and fertilizers. The fern grew within months and the bamboo, being nurtured for years, did not. But he still continued to nurture, and in the fifth year there was a sprout, and within next 6 months the tree grew 100 feet tall. The bamboo tree was growing underground, developing a root system strong enough to support its potential for outward growth. Had the tree not developed a strong foundation, it would not have sustained its life." This video is about getting back to the roots and strengthening our fundamentals. Hanuman, in aphorism number 6, says, "Unprejudiced observer takes note of nothing in every individual disease except the changes in the health of the body and of the mind. That is to say, he notices only the deviations from the former healthy state of the now diseased individual, which are felt by the patient himself, remarked by those around him, and observed by the physician. All these perceptible signs represent the disease in its whole extent, that is, together they form true and only conceivable portrait of disease." So we understand from this that the change from former healthy is important to form the portrait of the disease. Then Hanuman mentions in the aphorism 153 that PQRS symptoms are chiefly and most solely kept in view while selecting a specific homeopathic remedy. Each school of homeopathy has understood this aphorism in their unique way and contributed to the development of homeopathic science. But is there a reference given by Hanuman himself as to what, according to him, is a PQRS symptom? Aphorism 133 states, "On experiencing any particular sensation from the medicine, it is useful, indeed necessary, in order to determine the exact character of the symptom, to assume various positions while it lasts, to observe whether by moving the affected part, walking in the room or in the open air, by standing, sitting or lying, the symptom is increased, diminished or removed, and whether it returns on again assuming the position in which it was first observed, whether it is altered by eating or drinking or by any other condition, or by speaking, coughing, sneezing or any other action of the body, and at the same time to note the time of the day or night, it usually occurs in the most marked manner, whereby what is peculiar to and characteristic of each symptom will become apparent." We see through modalities, each symptom get its peculiarity. Hanuman has given a lot of emphasis to get the modalities of the case, and that is what makes the totality unique, individual and peculiar. So collection of all the changes from the former healthy state and getting the location, sensation, modality and concomitant together form the totality of the case. Similar approach was followed by Bonninghausen, who was Hanuman's favorite pupil, in his cases given in the therapeutic pocketbook. Let us understand this through a practical case example. 47-year-old male suffering from 102 fever and body ache since 1 week, diagnosed positive for COVID. Fever comes around 10 to 11 a.m. at midnight. He feels like lying down during the fever, as he could not even sit. The mouth is dry, he needs to drink water. He even gets up at night to drink water. Warm water causes nausea. desires covering during fever. He also complains of back pain, which is worse when he lies, and wants someone to press the back. Standing is uncomfortable, cannot tolerate light. He desires fruits, especially juicy fruits, and he is averse to meat. In order to form the totality, we take all the symptoms that have changed from his former healthy state. Symptom is a deviation from original healthy state. It is an alteration in the state of health during illness. For example, standing was never a problem before, but now it aggravates. The mouth used to not feel dry, but now it feels dry during fever. This is what makes a symptom, and the collection of these symptoms together forms the totality of the case. When we repertorize these symptoms, the remedy that has highest polarity difference is arsenic, and he receives arsenic album 204 hourly for 2 days. Arsenic, we know from our Materia Medica, has midday midnight aggravation, weakness, thirst, and chilly. So I was pretty confident that he would respond to this remedy. He responded pretty well to the remedy, and it was indeed a joy to see him well. This is what he sends me in a message. To summarize, how to form a totality? In order to form the portrait of disease, we should note the changes in the state of health in terms of location, sensation, modality, and concomitants, which together gives the case its peculiarity. This is a very fundamental aspect of homeopathy, and even if we keep doing this for each and every case, then we will be successful in majority of our cases. I can say this confidently because it has really helped me in my practice. Stick to the basics. Make sure the roots are strong so that the advances in the homeopathic system don't sway you. Choice is yours, to be a fern or a bamboo. Thank you for your time and attention. See you next time.